from being almost the ultimate Michigan family
yeah.
to being now like the ultimate Ohio State family. What's that process been like?
I guess it was a little weird at first, but, you know, in the end, it all ended up working out. So, I mean, I guess everything happens for a reason. So, I mean, in the end, you know, it all ended up working out. And, you know, my dad and, you know, my mom went there, obviously, to Michigan, too. You know, they had a lot of great things. You know, if they wouldn't have gone there, if we wouldn't, you know, my brothers and sister, you know, we would have never been born. So, I mean, I definitely have a respect, you know, up there and, you know, everything they do. But, you know, the changes, you know, we've, you know, my brothers, all of us have chosen, you know, in the end, it's worked out well for us. And, you know, I'm happy with where we're at.
How old were you when all the wardrobe and family went from blue and yellow to scarlet and gray?
I think I was like seventh grade. So I was in like junior high. Like,
what was it like?
I mean, it was a little different. So, I mean, it took a little while to get used to. I remember the first day I wore an Ohio State shirt. So, I mean, it took a little bit of time to get used to it. But, like I said, in the end, it all ended up working out. So, I'm happy where we are.
Did you actually, like, look in the mirror or anything?
Yeah, I mean, first day was definitely, it was a little weird, especially from, it was kind of two different extremes, so.
You really didn't look in the mirror?
No, I didn't do that, but, I mean, it was just kind of like, I mean, it was definitely weird, you know, growing up. I mean, I was basically, you know, I grew up basically Maize and Blue my whole life. And, you know, that, you know, the sudden change, you know, it was a little different. But like I said, in the end, it all ended up working out and I'm happy where I am.
The diversity in the run game, jet sweeps and getting outside and whatnot, how important is that to your success on offense?
You know, I think it helps out a lot because, you know, defenses can't really, you know, they can't really plan for one thing that we do. I mean, like you said, we run outside, we can run inside, you know, we can run outside or inside, you know, with reads, you know, depending on what the quarterback wants to do. And, you know, I mean, I think that's something that is pretty big for our offense. You know, it keeps defenses on edge, and, you know, it's something that definitely, I think, gives us an advantage.
What have you seen from the wide receivers, specifically Evan Spencer, in terms of their blocking and how much that's helped out?
Oh, yeah, totally. Yeah, when we're on the perimeter, basically, if any of those, you know, runs on the perimeter get out, I mean, it's almost all, you know, those wide receivers. You know, they've done a great job all year, and, you know, it's not something that you see every day in a wide receiver, but all those guys out there are selfless, you know, and, you know, they'll throw their bodies into even Zeke, too. You know, Zeke will be running on the edge, too. He throws a lot of great blocks when he's not running the ball, and, you know, I think it just shows how selfless those guys are. And like I said, I mean, the majority of that ball's kind of, you know, we get a big run around the outside, you know, it's always because one of the wide receivers or, you know, many of them had a great block out there, so.
Can you talk about the progress of the offensive?
You know, I mean, Virginia Tech game, you know, was rough. You know, definitely wasn't one of the brighter moments in our unit room. But, you know, it's something that game, you know, all the things that we messed up and all the things that we didn't do well in, you know, we learned from very quickly. And, you know, it's something that we took personally. And, you know, honestly, like I've said this now, knowing that we're where we are, you know, playing opportunity to play in the national championship, you know, I honestly wouldn't change that game because, I mean, our team grew tremendously from that game, you know, whether it's JT, the line, I mean, every position, you know, definitely made some big mistakes there. And, you know, we were kind of caught off guard. But, you know, in the end, it's something that made our team stronger. And I think it's the reason why we're here where we are today.
What's the personality like
from that game? Was there... When did you start seeing those lessons pay off?
You know, I think honestly the next week. I mean, we started preparing for, you know, stuff that maybe we weren't quite as good at as a unit and everything else. And like I said, I mean, every position, you know, I think, had, you know, some big mistakes in that game. It's something that we learned. And, you know, I remember that Sunday we came in and that was something that we focused on, all the things that we messed up. And, you know, I mean, it's something that, you know, it wasn't a quick change, but something that we kept building on, and, you know, we ended up making our weaknesses one of our strengths, so.